This is Janet Andrabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
In this video, we are going to solve the problem by applying the general expression of Newton's second law and calculating the linear momentum of the center of mass of a system.
Now let's move to application 1. Consider the figure. An object A of mass ma equal 2 kilograms is launched at t0 equals 0 with an initial velocity of magnitude 10 meters per second from the bottom of an inclined plane, making an angle 30 degrees with the horizontal. Another object B of mass mb 3 kilograms is released from rest from the top of the inclined plane at t0 equals 0. The magnitude of the friction force exerted by the incline on each object is 5 newtons. Now we will take the gravitational acceleration as 10 meters per second squared, and we neglect a resistance. Let's start with part 1. Apply Newton's second law to determine the expression of the algebraic value of pb. Now pb vector is the linear momentum of object p. So the system under study is b. Now what are the external forces acting on b? We have its weight, mbg, the normal force exerted by the incline, and the friction force. Now let's apply the general expression of Newton's second law. Sigma f external is equal to dp by dt. This is going to be mbg plus nb plus fb is equal to dpb by dt. Now we want to project all the vectors in this equation along the x-axis, which extends positively downward along the incline as shown in the figure. So let's start with mbg. Mbg gives you mbg sine alpha. If you want to draw mbg sine alpha on the figure, it is like that. So mbg sine alpha, or the x component of mbg, is in the positive x direction. So we have plus mbg sine alpha. Now the normal force is perpendicular to the x-axis, so it has no component along the x-axis. And the friction force is opposite to the positive x direction, so we have minus fb. Now this is going to be dpb by dt. Now we have mbg sine alpha plus 0 minus fb is equal to dpb by dt. The mass of object b is 3 kilograms. The gravitational acceleration is 10 meters per second squared. The sine alpha is 0.5 and the friction is 5 newtons. This is going to be 10 is equal to dpb by dt. Rearrange. Dpb is equal to 10 dt. Now take the antiderivative of both sides of this equation. This is going to be pb is equal to 10t plus constant. But what is this constant? This constant is the initial value of the algebraic value of the linear momentum of b. But remember that b is released from rest. So this is going to be 0. And finally, we have pb is equal to 10t.
Question number 2. Apply Newton's second law to determine the expression of the algebraic value of the linear momentum of A during its ascent. Now, the system is A. The external forces acting on A are its weight, which is vertically downward, the normal reaction, which is normal to the surface of the incline, and the friction force, Fa. As you see, Fa is directed along the x-axis. Since A moves from the bottom of the incline towards the top, and the friction is always opposite to its motion, so Fa is directed along the x-axis as shown. Now, applying Newton's second law, the sum of the external forces acting on A is equal to the time derivative of its linear momentum. The sum of the external forces is replaced by mag plus na plus Fa, which is equal to dpa by dt. Since the motion of A is rectilinear, so we project these forces along the x-axis. The projection of the weight along the x-axis is mag sine alpha. Pay attention. We do the projection along the x-axis and not along the motion of A. So the projection of the weight is plus mag sine alpha. And the projection of the normal reaction is zero, since n is normal to the x-axis. And the projection of the friction is plus Fa, as I said, since the friction is directed along the x-axis. Now, we have mag sin alpha plus Fa equal dpa by dt. Now, substitute for ma equal 2, g equal 10, sin alpha equal 0.5, Fa equal 5. So we get 15 equal dpa by dt. We make the cross product. We can write 15 dt equal dpa. Now we make the antiderivative both sides. The antiderivative of dpa is pa, and the antiderivative of 15 dt is equal to 15 t plus constant. The constant is equal to pa at t equals 0, but pa at t equals 0 is equal to ma times v0. Pay attention. Since A is launched from the bottom towards the top, so V0 is opposite to the x-axis. So its algebraic value is equal to minus 10 meters per second. Therefore, PA at T equals 0 is equal to minus 20 kilogram meter per second. Then substitute PA at T equals 0 instead of the constant. So PA equal 15T minus 20 SI units.
Focus, please. This is important.
Now, part C. Applying Newton's second law to determine the expression of the algebraic value of PG during the ascending of A. Now, recall that the center of mass G of the objects A and B moves like a particle of mass ma plus mb and acted upon by the net external force on the system AB. So the external forces acting on G are the external forces acting on A and B actually. Now let's apply the general expression of a Newton's second law. This is going to be so mag plus na plus mbg plus nb plus the friction forces is equal to dpg by dt. Now, as in the previous slides, we want to project all the vectors of this equation along the x-axis. So remember, mag gives you plus mag sine alpha because it is directed in the positive x direction. The normal forces give you zero. Mbg gives you mbg sine alpha. Now, Fa gives you plus Fa because it is in the positive x direction, while Fb gives you minus Fb because it is opposite to the positive x direction. Now we have mag sine alpha plus mbg sine alpha plus Fa minus Fb is equal to dpg by dt. Replace each physical quantity by its value. This is going to be 25 is equal to dpg by dt or pg prime, the first derivative of pg with respect to time. Rearrange. Now, take the antiderivative or the integral of both sides of this equation. This gives you pg is equal to the antiderivative or integral of 25 with respect to time. This is going to be pg is equal to 25t plus constant. But what is this constant? This constant is the initial algebraic value of the linear momentum of g. So this constant is equal to pg0, which is equal to pa0 plus pb0. PA0 and PB0 are given in the previous slides. So we have minus 20 plus 0, and the answer is minus 20 kilograms meters per second. And finally, PG is equal to 25T minus 20.
Question number 2. Use parts 1a and 1b to determine again the algebraic value of the linear momentum of the center of mass of the system AB. In part 1a, we found the linear momentum PA of A, and in part 1b, we found the linear momentum PB of B. But we know that the linear momentum of the center of mass of a system is equal to the vector sum of the linear momentum of the particles that constitute the system. So PG equal PA plus PB. But PA is found as 15t minus 20. So PA as a vector equal 15t minus 20 times I, where I is a unit vector along the x-axis. Similarly, PB as algebraic equal 10t, but PB as a vector equal 10ti. Therefore, the linear momentum of the center of mass is equal to 25t minus 20i, which is a vector quantity. So the algebraic value of the linear momentum of the center of mass is given by 25t minus 20 in SI. Question number 3. Determine the time needed by A to stop. We know that the linear momentum of A is equal to 15t minus 20. As you know, when A stops, its speed becomes zero. When the speed becomes zero, so its linear momentum is also becomes zero according to this relation. Therefore, 15t minus 20 is equal to zero. Therefore, t equal 1.33 seconds.
Now, part 4. Determine the algebraic value of the velocity of the center of mass g of the system AB at t equal 0.5 seconds. You know that PG is equal to MA plus MB into VG. As we have seen in part 1c, PG is equal to 25T minus 20. Now, replace MA and MB by their values. Now, this is going to be VG is equal to 5T minus 4. Now, we want to calculate VG at T equal 0.5 seconds. So replace t in the expression of Vg by 0.5. This is going to be Vg is equal to minus 1.5 meters per second.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.